So once you create your account and sign in to Hal9, you'll get here, hal9.com/build. And you can see here on the UI, we have a text box for your prompts and questions. In this case, it's disabled because I haven't selected a file to work with. I'll start here, analyze your own CSV file. And you can upload CSV files from your computer here or select from previously uploaded files from this list. I'm going to select this file with information about digital marketing campaigns. And let's imagine that I want to know what is the ad type with the highest average engagement. And when I hit enter, you can see Hal9 generating Python code in the background. If we were using the Hal9 version that connects to a database, we would see SQL code being generated first, and then the Python code would process it and visualize it. So in this case, you can see here the response to my question is image. I also got a chart here with the three different ad types where I can compare them. I can save this chart with this button. But let's imagine that I want actually to add a filter per campaign, because I want to compare the campaigns that we have. So while this loads, let me show you the data that I'm using. This is a Google Sheets file, and it doesn't matter if you use Excel or any other source of data. Just make sure that when you export it as a CSV file, you don't get any invalid characters in your file or contradictory data types. If that happens, when you upload it to Hal9, you'll get an error. So probably it has to do with a point or a comma somewhere in your file that is confusing Hal9. So this is the response that I got. You can see here the chart and the answer that we were previously seeing, but now this depends on this filter where I can select the winter sale campaign or the summer sale campaign, and we can see the data switching according to this filter. We can also provide feedback about this. And since I'm happy with this, I want to share it with my team. I'll hit save. I can name it my ads report, let's call it. I can also change the URL name that I'm going to generate. I can write a description, and I can select the privacy level that I want for this URL. So we have private, that means only I can see it. Unlisted means that only people with the URL can see it. And public means that anyone can see it, even from outside the URL, right? So if people see my profile page, they'll see these dashboards or these applications. You can also see here the URL for embedding. So this is one of the great features of Hal9. You can embed this visualization inside your website or somewhere else in the internet. This is the URL for that. We will upload some tutorials about this soon. And when I hit save, you can see the URL changing from /build to /my username/ the name of this visualization. And this is the URL that I can copy paste and use to share with someone else on the internet, right? I also want to show you this feature under settings. When I click this checkbox, I enable this feature that allows me to see the code behind the application that I got. So basically you can audit, debug, or even modify the code behind your dashboard very easily. This is a code editor, so you can just write, I'm just going to write a comment so I didn't modify anything. And every time I modify that code, the application will reload and adapt to the new code that I just wrote. So this is great in case you want to make sure the code is doing what it's supposed to do. And basically this is the basic functionality of Hal9. Remember that We're using CSV file that has to do with the basic plan that allows you to ask questions from any number of CSV files. There are not limitations in terms of number of questions or the number of viewers that can see and interact with your applications or your dashboards. So yeah, enjoy this and happy chatting with your data.